The Caribbean island of Trinidad is the largest of the Lesser Antilles. Just 7 miles off the coast of Venezuela, it also is the southernmost of all Caribbean islands. Due to this proximity to the mainland, it was the most heavily populated island in the pre-Columbian Caribbean, its inhabitants a mix of Arawaks and Caribs. Its first encounter with Europeans came in 1498, with Columbus's arrival on his third voyage to the New World. Like the rest of the Caribbean, Trinidad's discovery led to colonization and slavery. However, Trinidad maintained a diverse culture even under these conditions, home to many surviving Caribs and free people of color throughout the colonial period. British emancipation in the 1830s made Trinidad a magnet for other free men, and the Indian workers brought in to fill the post-slavery labor gap only added to the diversity. Following emancipation, Trinidad's black population developed its own version of pre-Lenten carnival. Originally called canboulé, from the French word for burnt cane, it brought together many of the elements that came to define Trinidad's music. Sugarcane was Trinidad's primary export. It also was a key element in the developing music. Along with bamboo, it was used in the tambu bamboo ensembles, It also provided the weaponry for stick fighting. This martial art, called Kalinda, originated in Angola and the Congo, and the drumming that accompanies it also influenced Trinidad's popular music. Trinidad's version of the African griot, who came to be called a chantwell, documented the community's history and commented on society, often making fun of their white rulers. All of these ingredients, the canboulé masquerade, rhythms from Kalinda, the satirical chantwell songs, and the competitive nature of stick fighting, came together to create the earliest calypso. In 1914, Jules Sims made the first calypso record in Trinidad. The Road March became a major part of Carnival. An annual competition for Carnival's Road March Anthem and Calypso King began in 1932. Reflecting the highly competitive nature of Calypso, many singers assumed intimidating names, drawing from wild animals or fearsome rulers. The 1930s were an early golden age, led by the Roaring Lion, who won Road March Award 4 years straight.
Just get to the boat. DJ, was bacchanal. The whole island played carnival. People were jumping to and fro to the rhythm of a red hot calypso. Here they're singing all day, all night, Miss Marian. Down by the seaside, she's sifting sand. Strings on a banjo can tie a boat. Water from the ocean can sail a boat. Come up, Mr. Poleman.
During World War II, American GIs stationed in Trinidad discovered Calypso and helped spread its popularity beyond the island. They also provided a new subject for the composer's sharp wits.
And when the Yankees first went to Trinidad, some of the young girls were more than glad. They said that the Yankees treat them nice. And they give them a better price. They buy rum and Coca-Cola. When down Point Kumana,
Lord Invader's rum and Coca-Cola became Trinidad's first international sensation when covered by the Andrews Sisters.
If you ever go down Trinidad, they make you feel so very glad. Calypso sing and make up rhyme, guarantee you one real good fine time. Drinking rum and Coca-Cola, go down Point Cumana. Both mother and daughter, working for the Yankee dollar. Oh, beat it, man, beat it.
Another distinctive sound from Trinidad's carnival developed in the 1940s. The steel pans, metal variations on the Nambu Tambu ensembles, are tuned percussion instruments originally fashioned from discarded oil drums. The 1950s saw the arrival of the Mighty Sparrow, one of Trinidad's greatest calypsonians. His first road march winner completed a circle, commenting on the departure of American soldiers and promoting his readiness to take over from them.
This was your name, Caitlin, from the top. Just to leave the sheen and Dinah.
The 60s and 70s belonged to Lord Kitchener, who won 10 road marches in 14 years, still a national record.
I walk around my room and I started to create. I know how to prove to them I have the ability. I dare and then decide the minor should terminate. If not entirely, for most of the melody, you know that the chorus carries a symbol. From E7 to A minor, it really designed to give you a strange new look on the road to Panorama. They said Casablanca, Stalivan Invader, and someone from Arima. They mastered A minor, but I know you can trust. So they are next year, that's all we'll be hoping to. This track is tomorrow. You will hear Pan in E minor with a steel band from all over. You're gonna hear them at the best, you're going through a test. You're gonna hear them at the pass, burning the grass. Beat Pan, Beat Pan, Beat Pan. We'll be right back.
The following decade brought dramatic change to Trinidad's music establishment. In 1977, Calypso Rose became the first woman to win the Road March competition, a feat she repeated the following year. The 70s also saw a pair of musical fusions rewriting the rules. First, Lord Shorty released an album that melded calypso with American soul music. This soul calypso, or soca, would grow and evolve to become the dominant force in Trinidad music.
Rosalie from Fontabelle, she have her brains in hell. Accidentally met, now it seems I can't forget. This Bajan girl, my Rosalie, Rosalie. Never thought a Bajan woman could be so sweet to me. Darling, I love you, I don't know what to do. You're too sweet, you're too sweet, you're too sweet. Oh, gosh, you must be sweet. You're too sweet, you're too sweet.
Not everybody was happy with this development. Older Calypsonians especially lamented the lyrical shallowness they saw in the new music.
The music singing for them, mostly the music. A man sing a line, the music play 5 minutes.
That is soca, a stronger beat with less lyrics.
I can't understand it at all.
However, soca pushed Trinidad and its neighboring islands back into the global spotlight. In 1983, a Montserrat musician called Arrow had a major international hit with the song Hot, Hot, Hot. The second fusion came from Trinidad's Indian community, when Sundar Popo added elements of his own ethnic music to calypso and created a new genre that would come to be known as chutney, named after a traditional Indian side dish.
Children do their own things and parents get the shame. Children do their wrong things.
Soca continues to be internationally popular, having assimilated elements of electronic dance music in recent years.
But I like it so, cause I put them in the mood. It's all yeah that we waited. Oh yeah.